control. Not so it's gonna fool you. I might have fucked up the word, but it's all good. But anyway, welcome to another episode of Junior's World of Soul. This is actually a special episode. As you can hear, I came in with CC and the Music Factory. But this video is not about them. This video is about the vocalist that sung this song. And if you're thinking the video and you're thinking about that skinny model, it was not her. And back then, we knew it was not her. The only skinny black girl that we knew that can sing and have vocals like that was Whitney Houston. And Whitney Houston was not in that video. But the voice I am talking about is Miss Martha Wash. Martha Wash is so underrated, y'all. And it's crazy. And I felt like I had to do this video. And what makes it so crazy is I've been wanting to do this video for the longest. I've been pushing it back and pushing it back. And I was just like, yo, I already had it written. I was ready to do it and everything. And I just kept, you know, prolonging it. You know what I'm saying? And it was just like, nah, you know, I don't think it's right. But then it was like, you know what? It's time to do it. I need to give Martha her respect. Even though, you know, Unsung did a video on, you know, like a show on her being the Unsung, and she definitely is. And that was another reason why I actually felt like I had to do this video, because tonight on Unsung, they're doing a video on what's his name? Frank Knuckles, and on house music. And I was watching it, and I was just like, yo, boom, I need to go ahead and do this video on Martha Wash. So in this video, it's my story and my introduction on her and her music and how she became one of my favorite singers of all time. She's in my top 10. I love her. I told her that on social media, too. But let's get y'all drinks. I got mine, and let's drive vibes to some good music by the Queen of Clubland. And if y'all know that, that's on her website, and I'm put that in the more info box, so y'all can check that out, too. But now, y'all know that my family is soul heads, and we love soul music. So on the, you know, the weekends is really when our love for soul really, really comes out. So, you know, this was how I was really first introduced to Martha Wash's music, and it was this song right here. And it goes a little something like this. Here we go. Choo-choo, my whole life you. So when my mom played that one day, I remember asking moms, I was like, Mom, she sound good. Who is that? Because I thought it was just her and there's maybe like a background vocalist. And my mom was like, oh, no, baby, that's Two Tones for Fun. And I was like, oh, Two Tones for Fun. She was like, it's two big girls that can sing. And I was like, oh, for real? And she was like, yeah. She was like, their names are Martha Wash and Azora. That's what my mom, we didn't know her last name, but it's Armstead. And, you know, because mom is funny. If she, we and her are bad when it comes to names. So my mom was just like Azora, and she knew Martha Wash. And I was like, oh, okay. And she was like, well, you know, they used to be background singers for Sylvester. So then I looked at her, and I was like, well, who the heck is Sylvester? And she was like, Sylvester was fabulous. And back then, I didn't know what the heck mama was talking about, because I'm like, fabulous. I'm just thinking, oh, great. That means he's great. My mom was like, oh, no, he's fabulous. And I'm like, I'm looking at her like, now I'm like, oh, that's what you meant. But mom's was all about the music. That's for one thing. So, you know, the history lesson began, and she played this song first just to kind of let me know who Sylvester was. And this was the song, and goes a little something like this. Here we go. So I was like, Mom, why is his voice so high? I was like, my mom was like, hi, that brother can sing. So then, she was like, you know, then I was like, well, Mom, what does he look like? So I, you know, I think she brought out the vinyl cover of this song, and she showed me, and I was like, Mom, why is he dressed like that? I was like, he looked like a female. My mom was like, why are you worrying about what he looked like? I just showed you what he looked like. You just listen. Don't he sound good? I was like, yeah, he sound good. She was like, then why are you worrying about what he dressed like? Forget about that. Get your mind out of that. Worry about the music. Mom got me together early, y'all, off the break. Mind you, I was only like 9, 10 years old, but Mom got me together early. She was like, I don't think so. This is what you're not going to do. You're not going to, it don't matter. You hear that talent, and that's what she was all about. So I was like, oh, okay. So she was like, that was Sylvester. So she was like, then Martha and Azora sung background for him. And I was like, oh, that, and she was like, two tons of fun. And she was like, well, this is the song where you can kind of really hear them. And she played this, and it goes a little something like this. Hope y'all getting a nice rock to it, but here we go. Come on. So when I heard it, I was like, oh, Mom, okay, I can hear them now. When she like, yeah, she was like, that's them. So right there, y'all, was like my first introduction to Martha Wash. And I kept that there, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, time went on, you know what I'm saying? And that was, I think I was introduced to her when I was like 9. And that was my first introduction to her. So time goes on and time passes and, then, you know, we're in South Carolina, and, you know, Video Soul was hot, you know what I'm saying, with Donnie Simpson and Sherry Carter. Y'all know about that, you know what I'm saying, that's when it was popping, you know what I'm saying. So then this came on, and here we go, and it begins from here. Come on. I hit it. But I remember watching the video, and I was like, Mom, that sound like Martha Wash. And my mom said, yeah, it is. But that girl in the video ain't Martha Wash. So we watching the video thinking we going to see Martha Wash, and we never saw her. My mother was like, hold on, there's some trickery going on. Because that ain't that skinny black girl that's in that video. My mom said, I done known Martha Wash for years. Who is this girl? So I was like, uh-oh. And my mom was like, yes, there is some real trickery going on up in here. So my mom was like, that's fine. So, you know, we watched the video. Mom caught an attitude. I'm just looking at her like she's pissed because she was like, that's not fair. What is going on here? So then after that, Mom had to break it down. My mom was like, now, there's a lot of other songs that Martha was on, but she wasn't in the video. So this wasn't the first time my mom was seeing this. So she was pissed because she like, here we go again. And it was like, whoa. So Mom was like, we going to bring it back. And she was like, these are some of the songs that you know, but the video makes you think it was somebody else. So I'm like, oh, okay, so what's the songs you talking about? She was like, here we go. And Mom gave me a medley, y'all. She gave me a nice medley. And this was the first song she played. And it goes a little something like this. Everybody. And I was just looking at my like, that was Martha. She was like, don't it sound like her? I was like, yeah. She was like, but in that video, Martha ain't in that video, is she? And I was like, no. She was like, exactly. She was like, oh, there's more. So I was like, okay. And my mom goes in, y'all. When she's mad, she goes in on the music because she's pissed off because she felt like the image, they wanted a skinny girl, and it wasn't right. You know what I mean? And she was absolutely right. And here you go. Here's the next one. And then, like, my mouth just dropped. I was like, what? So when I heard that, I was like, what? Now, in my mind, I done heard this so many times, and I'm like, that was Martha, too? I was like, and my mom looking at me like, boy, I let you hear Two Tons of Fun. I let you hear Sylvester, Disco Heat, and you gonna tell me you didn't realize that was Martha? And she was like, oh, my child, my child. So then she kept going. I was just like, oh, my God, this ain't ending. So here we go. This is a slow ballad, but me not thinking, hearing this song over and over again, I'm like, oh man, I done messed up here, but here's the next one. It goes a little something like this. I'm like, give me a second, y'all. Sorry with the music. Don't get me wrong, hold, give me a second. Like, whoa, I was like, wow, and mind you, I'm just like, this is crazy right here, this is nuts. And then she played the last song, she played this, and she played this, and it was just like, I'm done, I just couldn't believe it. Mind you, I'm like, yeah, I think I was, because I thought I was 9 when she introduced me to Martha Wash, but I think I was like 5 or 6, actually. But I'm 9 years old at this part here, knowing that these were Martha Wash and didn't know it was her. But here we go. Now, mind you, y'all, I've been hearing these songs for years. And I'm like, yo, that was Martha Wash. And I'm like, in my mind, I'm like, I'm so messed up because I'm like, yo, I know who Martha Wash is, but these videos were telling me something else. And then, you know, then I started to think the whole Milli Vanilli thing. And my mother was like, it's a Milli Vanilli mess going on because that was not Martha that was in that video. And she was like, a lot of these videos, Martha wasn't in it. And it was so crazy, that same day that my mom was giving me this medley on songs that Martha has been on that's been big records, then we were watching Video Soul after that. And they were so shady then that they threw this video on as a throwback. And I was like, I cannot take it. And I was like, this is crazy. Hold on. So Rebe, so I'm like, okay, I'm watching the video. Mom watching, you know, she playing and we listen to it and my mom was like, mm-hmm. She's just sitting there waiting and I'm like, okay, we talking about Martha. I'm hearing Rebe. So I'm like, I remember that song. I was like, oh yeah, that song goes hard, you know what I'm saying? So it gets to this part right here, y'all, and I was like, oh snap. And this is in the video. And here we go. And this part Mama was waiting for. So I'm like, Mama, that's Martha too? She was like, now for... I was like, whoa, this is crazy right here. So many times I've heard that. I was like, I'm thinking that whole thing is Rebe. And my mom went, you really thought that was Rebe hitting them high notes? She looking at me like, boy, please. So I'm like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, I'm sorry, Ma. Like, I didn't know. You know what I'm saying? You're ignorant to things until you start learning things. You know what I'm saying? And then when it got to this, because, you know, my mom had the, you know, we had the long version. Because in the video, they don't, you know, we get like the 3-minute version. But then we get in this part right here. And this one, I was like, okay, yeah, this is Martha Wash. You thinking, you know what I mean? As a kid, I'm like, when I saw this video, I'm thinking it's Rebe. I'm like, Rebe can sing her face off. And my mom was like, no, baby, that was not Rebe. That was not Rebe, baby. So, as y'all can see, I'm in total shock. But the one thing that y'all can see, my mom schooled me on things before there was the internet. You know, now you can go to the internet and you can research and find things. We didn't have that back then. We had people were doing autobiographies, and you were watching, like, the news, or you get, you know, Ebony and Jet and Essence, and that's where you kind of got, you know, your research from, you know what I mean? And Mom was on it, you know what I'm saying? And that was just a beautiful thing about me learning from her, because it's like, there was no internet. So she couldn't, I just couldn't go to the internet then and be like, oh, okay, that was Martha Wash singing background vocals. No. You had to know your music and then kind of put two and two together, and then there it goes. And that's why my mom has so much music knowledge, and that's where I get it from. So, yeah, so I had to give that shout out to my mom, you know, all that good stuff. But so fast forward, we're back in New York. We're back in New York, and it's a Saturday, and I think we were going to Brooklyn to go visit some family members and things like that. And my mom had to run into the dollar store. So me and her going to the dollar store, mom get what she get, but during that time, they had like a music section where they sold tapes, cassettes. Lord, it was still cassettes being sold, y'all, for a dollar. So my mom went there, and I remember she found Martha Wash. And my mom was like, now, you remember Martha Wash, the Two Thirds of Fun, and Sylvester? And I was like, well, yeah. And she was like, I was like, oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah, the lady that sung Just Us, and, you know, the lady that they didn't put her in the videos, but that was her singing. She was like, yeah. She was like, well, Martha Wash ended up taking, you know, that group CC Music Factory and Black Box. She took them to court. And I said, oh, okay. And she was like, well, she took them to court, and she ended up getting a record deal out the deal, and then she made an album. And I was like, oh, for real? So mind you, I'm getting a history lesson in the dollar store, mind you. So I'm like, oh, okay. So after like 5 minutes of this history lesson, her mom going back and forth telling me stuff that she already did. But I'm just sitting listening, because sometimes you don't get everything. You know what I'm saying? So after like 5 minutes, my mom was like, oh, my God, I've been trying to find this. And now they have it. So we brought it. And it was a white cassette. I'll never forget it. And mom put it in. And y'all, the first thing I heard out of those speakers was this, and it was a beautiful thing. Goes a little something like this. Here we go. That just hearing Martha sing just does something to me, yo. Like, I be feeling like I be wanting to hit them high notes like her when I know I can't. It's just like she give you that feeling, and I was just like, oh my God. And the banger started. So I hope y'all ready to dance a little bit, giving y'all a little sample of this album. And here we go. And this joint goes a little something like this. Joy, That's one thing. When me and mom is chilling and we getting our sip on a little bit, I always throw this song on, and this will get the party right. We'll be like, okay, it's going to be a good night. You know what I'm saying? So then the next joint is when I play this now, it's like, yo, me and mom be wanting to get out the car because I always play it when we're in the car, like at a stoplight. And then, yo, my mom one time got out and started dancing. This is how we love this song. But here we go. It goes a little something like this. Here we go. Y'all, I lie to y'all not. We was on Route 1 in New Jersey going back home. And I threw that song on. My mom literally got out at the stoplight, and I was blasting in my car, and she was out there just rocking, y'all. It was crazy, y'all. But the light was red, so people couldn't even get mad. But when it turned green, she hopped on back in. But here's the next banger. Diana Ross did it on the Double Platinum movie with Brandy. And, you know, but Martha Wash did it first. But here is this. Right here. Woo! I carry on! Woo! Bangers after bangers, y'all. Bangers, bangers. Then this joint, I'm giving y'all bangers, man. I wish I could play the whole thing for y'all so y'all could kind of rock off a little bit. But y'all know YouTube be acting stupid, so I can't do that. But here's the next banger. Goes a little something like this. Yo, it's like, I'm telling y'all, Martha has bangers on this album, yo. And then, you know, she took it back and made us see what we fell in love with her to begin with back in the 70s. And she gave us this, but she added her own little thing to it. And I played this in the beginning of the video. And it goes a little something like this. Here we go. I think this thing acts stupid. Feeling mighty friendly. See that? My heart like you. Yeah, man. But on that album, my favorite song on the album is actually a slow song. And I love this song because I love her vocal acrobatics on it, the run she do. Martha's voice is just so soothing to me, and it makes me feel so good just listening to her. But this song right here is my favorite from her. I want to see her do this live, and it would be amazing. And here is Now That You're Gone, and I'm going to give y'all two spots where she goes off. Here we go. And then this part at the end where she goes in, y'all, is classic Martha. And this is what really, and I be, y'all, I be cleaning the house, y'all. I know my neighbors be pissed off, but I don't care. I goes in, and I be playing the hell out of this. And then when this part come out, I just go to my speakers and start blasting it. But here we go. Hold on for love. Their mom always coming with this. Woo! Yes, indeed, man. Martha kills this, y'all. I swear I'm gonna put all this music in the more info box so y'all can check this out, man. So, y'all know me by this time. I'm getting more into my research, trying to figure out who did what, who did who. And I found out that Brian Alexander Morgan did half of this album. And if you don't know who Brian Alexander Morgan is, he's produced for so many people. But I think everybody knows him from this. And it goes a little something like this. I don't know what to do, boy, you got me so confused. Alexander Morgan did damn near the whole album of SWV. He's done so many people, and he's become one of my favorite producers of all time, man. And he did Half of Martha's, and I love going back and forth with him on Twitter, and I love to tell him how I love what he did for Martha Wash. He created some bangers from her. You know what I'm saying? The slow song he produced was from her, because you can hear him on the background. And that's why when Mary did the London sessions, it kind of reminded me a little bit of the Martha Wash album. You know what I mean? And that's why I told him, and I love that. And like I said, it was so great to find out that he, you know, really produced some great, great ballads, and he produced some great bangers from her. So I tell him that all the time, but now y'all got a feeling of who Alexander Morgan is. But, y'all, let me tell y'all, that cassette cost us $1, but I really think I have spent over about a good $35 over getting Martha Wash. I have brought it on Amazon about 3 times, and my mom brought it. Well, I brought it. And then she gave me the money. Or did she? Mama probably ain't even give me the money. But anyway, it's like maybe like $7, $8 on Amazon for the CD. I've got it about 4 times. That's how much we love the album, because it's amazing. It's underrated. You know what I'm saying? And during that time, this was 93, you know, it was definitely club-oriented. It was definitely more house-oriented, so it really didn't get the exposure that it should have gotten. And also, quote-unquote, it was the image problem. And that's what I hated, man. And it's like that now, when it's so unfair. You have so many talented people that's not getting the love and respect that they deserve because of an image. And a lot of these chicks are skinny. Like, you know, you know, R.I.P. the Phila Thompson. I just put up a clip of her talking about it. She said, you know, I've been doing my craft for so many years, but the record label would rather get some little skinny chick off the street that can't even hardly sing, put some weave in her hair, make her look cute, and can't carry a note, and she has a hit record. It's so unfair, and it's not right, and it pisses me off, because Martha Wash should be so much bigger than what she is, because that 1993 album that she released on RCA is a classic to me. 5 mic classic for me. It's definitely in my top 25, for real, for real. But after hearing that album, Martha became one of my favorite singers of all time. And then going back and listening to things, and it was just like, yo, her voice is just amazing, man. And it's just like, it really bothers me that, you know, she's so underrated. And people don't understand it. Martha has been on a lot of hits. And you don't even know it, because she played the background and they cheated her out. You know what I'm saying? CeCe and the Music Factory got a #1 record and she wasn't on it. That song sold like 5 million copies. And she didn't get a dime for it, because they told her that it was just going to be a demo. That was it. She was just doing a little demo here and there. It wasn't going to go nowhere. And they ended up screwing her. That's just not fair. But anyway, like I said, I go online now and I just watch her live performances, because she be in the club and it be thumping, but that voice still shines through and it's a beautiful thing. But here's a couple of samples of live performances that she do, that you can hear Martha and hear that voice. You know what I'm saying? And the first one I'm going to give y'all is the Disco Heat, and I love that, because I love when her and Azora and Sylvester kind of go back and forth, because Sylvester got them gospel vocals. That's why you can hear his high pitch, but he got that gospel in him, yo. And then Martha and Azora come in with their gospel voices too. Beautiful, man. But I love how this performance starts, and you can hear Martha right off the break. You can hear that voice she just has. And Here we go. Here is Disco Heat, and they kill it. Oh, Martha. I love that. I love that. When she, oh my God. And then at the end, like they just go off at the end. And Martha really goes off in this part. And here we go. So I also, that's one, that's Disco Heat, a live performance. The next one I heard when I was a kid, and I think my mom actually played it, and that was actually the first time I might have heard of Martha, but didn't know it was her. But then after, you know, knowing who Martha Wise is, and now hearing it, it was like, wow. But this performance of You Are My Friend, because Sylvester was such a big fan of Patty, he did it live, and he did a live album in San Francisco, and they did You Are My Friend. Let me tell y'all, that live performance of You Are My Friend, I would have loved to see that up close, because the talent that they were displaying in this performance, and you could tell the love that they had for each other, it was just great. And I'm just going to let you hear Martha's part, and here we go, and it goes a little something like, and he just let Martha go, y'all, and it was just a beautiful thing. Here we go. Oh, no, not that part, not that part. Hold up. Let's go back, bring it back a little bit. Here we go. She's about to go in. Woo! Yo, let me tell you something, y'all. I recommend y'all listen to that whole thing. Sylvester, Azora, and Martha goes in. It would have been, I wish somebody had like a video so we can really see it, because it was amazing. The next one. Since we near Christmas, the Christmas holiday, you know, I love this. I play it every Christmas now. Sometimes my family gets sick of it, but I don't care, and I'm going to continue to keep playing it. And it's her version of Silent Night, and she just sings, y'all. She just sings, and here we go. Ooh-wee. Go from there. I'm going to go from here. We're going to go from there. And then hold up, I gotta give y'all three parts of this video. Sing, Martha, sing. Go in. Woo! Did y'all see that run right there, y'all? Oh my God. But then she goes in at this part, and this is what I love, because Martha know how to end a song, and this part right here. Mary, Jesus Christ, Lord have mercy. Woo! That, I'm telling y'all, yo, that part right there, if you don't feel nothing, something is wrong with you. Oh, my God. So those are the couple of live performances that I have so y'all can understand why I love Martha and why I love her voice so much. And the one that I definitely, she did a duet with Luther. And this duet really was supposed to be for Anita Baker, but him and Anita Baker had some problems, but he put Martha on it, and I'm glad that he did, because this is a favorite duet of mine. And everybody talks about, you know, his duets that he do. And I don't think a lot of people talk about this duet. Everybody kind of go to the one with him and Cheryl Lynn, If This World Were Mine, and, you know, him and Mariah, Endless Love. But I like this. This is my favorite Luther duet. And it's I Who Have Nothing, him and Martha Wash. And I'm just giving y'all her parts, but she sounds amazing as usual. And goes a little something like this. Here we go. Go on, Martha, sing for him.
She could give you the world, but she'll never love you the way.
Woo! And then her and Luther gets down at the end. But I love this part right here, and them two, like, just go in and... Woo! Come on, man. Martha and Luther gets down on this joint, y'all. Oh, my God, man. I love this joint. But... you know, those are a couple, like, you know, joints that I just want y'all to hear how beautiful Martha Wash's voice is. She deserves so much more respect than what she gets. I love her voice. Like I said, she's in my top favorite singers of all time. And that's why I felt like I wanted to do this video, just to give her the respect, how much I love her, you know, you know, and I hope by this video y'all go back and listen to these songs and realize that Martha was a force to be reckoned with. She's unsung hero, in my opinion, because a lot of careers wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for her. And we talking about in the 90s where that Milli Vanilli bull crap was going on. You know what I'm saying? But Martha's still out there doing her thing. She's still touring. You know what I'm saying? Still putting out music. I stalk her site so much because I'll be wanting to hear new music from her. But, yeah, but Martha, I love you. Like I told you on Twitter, and we was having a conversation on Twitter, I have so much love for you. You have definitely become part of my family. You are, like, up there with Mary J. Blige. Mary J. Blige is a big part of my family. You're another artist that's a big part of our family, because that album we play all the time. We got my grandfather liking it. We got my grandma liking it. We got my uncle liking it. You know, we play it for so many people, and they really enjoy it. And they be like, oh, that's Martha Wash. That's funky. You know what I'm saying? So... hopefully, I hope Martha gets to see this video and see my craziness, but also see the love that I have for her and the respect that she deserves. And for all that, I'm going to end with a song on her that 93 album. And it goes a little something like this. Here we go. Woo! Tight and don't let go. I'm out, y'all. Love you, Martha Wash.